I want to show you some of the track automation settings and how they work. We can get to it under the preferences menu here, automation, or from the shortcut in the shortcut bar if you have it visible, or from track automation, automation preferences. Now we have an option when you're moving regions in the data that contain track automation, you can have logic never move the automation with it, always move the automation with it, or ask you if you want to move the automation with it. Very important setting, and include trails if possible. Snap offset we've looked at when you're snapping to the beat or grid, that's an offset amount. Ramp time is important. I want to show you how this works. When you're using touch mode, ramp time dictates how long it'll take for when you release the mouse from the fader or the finger from your control surface, how long it'll take for the fader to ramp back up or down to the previous value. Right now it's at 200 milliseconds, which is pretty quick. Let me put this in touch mode and I'm going to show you how it works. So there, I moused the fader, and when I released my finger from the mouse, that's how long it took to go back down. Now, let's call up the options again, and let's set it to a much higher value. Let me type in, let's say 800. Now watch what happens. Now it's a much longer gradual decline back to the previous value. Let's go back to the preferences, and finally we have settings for write mode. When you finish using write mode, what do you want it to revert to? You can alternate between the familiar automation modes. And finally, what you want write mode to apply to, which specific parameters. And also in preferences, under display in the arrange tab, you can control the transparency of the automation lines in relation to the region data here.